Rolling as the woman convicted of a huge skimming scam walks out of court.
Yeah, many of us have been victimized by identity thieves. Nationwide, thieves steal billions each year through this most common type of fraud.
Today in Orlando federal court, a woman who admits skimming dozens of people's credit cards in return for cash and gift cards avoided jail time.
And this WESH 2 News exclusive, Bob Keeling, live outside the federal court with more on how she stayed out of the slammer and why. Bob?
Well, and Jim, prosecutors pointed out that this woman was the actual person who betrayed dozens of customers by taking credit cards and putting them through a skimming device. But she pointed out that she had no record prior to this and stole out of need, not greed.
We ain't about it.
Outside federal court today, family members of 32-year-old LaShonda Rogers were lighthearted, clearly relieved she was sentenced to 3 years probation, not prison. Earlier, Rogers pleaded guilty to conspiracy to skim customers' credit cards in return for $1,500 in cash and gift cards. Rogers sobbed as she told federal magistrate Gregory Presnell that she stole credit card information out of need, not greed, to pay her 4-year-old son's medical bills. She told us she didn't want people to find out what she'd done.
And I'd just like to see. Yeah, I don't want to be on the news, so nobody don't know but y'all. So.
Well, is there anything you'd want to tell all those folks who had their identities compromised? In May and June of last year, federal court papers indicate Rogers received a skimmer like this one from the mastermind of the scheme and stole up to 40 credit card numbers. She was caught only when security cameras at her unnamed place of employment captured her placing her hands under her desk, appearing to swipe them. When confronted by Secret Service agents, Rogers turned in the two men she says put her up to it. In return, she received a downward departure in her sentence and was ordered to pay more than $13,000 in restitution. By the time Rogers was ready to drive away, her family's attitude had changed.
You got a problem with yourself? You better leave her alone. You do too.
Now, Rogers admits she was the so-called intake person, if you will, stealing the credit card numbers. Coming up all new in our next half hour, you'll find out from the sentence of the mastermind of this scheme exactly how much money may have been stolen as a result. That's all new at 5. Reporting live at the Orlando Federal Courthouse, Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.